you talk about the design of the car, we always have the challenge to link it to the rest of the family, but as well we would like to give each and every car its own characteristics. In the case of the Michelin Cross Turismo, we really put the focus on trying to combine different vehicle characteristics, as well shown what you can do with the car. If you have a business meeting in the city, just take the car, but if you decide in the evening to go out to the beach or in the mountains, no problem, this car can handle this as well. So that was really the focus for this concept. We wanted to visualize very obviously that this is a new technology. So for example, on the front with the headlamps, this is very characteristic for this type of car. The light band in the rear is much more than a tail lamp. It is as well used to communicate between the user and the car. The rear light band indicates as well if the car is charging or not. We intend as well to use it to communicate with other people in the traffic. If you take the front, the fenders are higher than the hood. Now with a car that doesn't have this huge block of iron anymore in the front, we get even more freedom. On the interior, I think the challenge is even bigger to connect the old world with the new world or the future. But for example, if you take the instrument, we have this driver-oriented instrument. The graphic is resembling, let's say, the old instruments and gives you really this feeling to be, as a driver, still the most important person in the car. A lot of people were surprised by the concept itself. So I think we managed to do something, in a way, something new.
Please welcome the Vice President Style of Porsche AG, Michael Mauer.
Michael, you and your team have done a fantastic design. Can you tell about the idea and some details of the concept?
Yeah, the first thing you realize on this car is the off-road look. So, for example, the protection areas in the lower part of the bumper, or the rugged wheel arches, or the striking look of the side skirts. But apart from this, it is a typical Porsche with all the typical design elements, the section over the hood that reminds you of a 911, or the four-point headlamps, or the roof that is dropping to the rear, the famous Porsche Flyline.
Michael, when you look at the rear, we have the full-length light strip with a black glass finish and the Porsche lettering.
Yeah, we put a lot of focus on this light band because in the case of the Cross Turismo, it is much more than just a tail lamp. It is as well used for the communication between the user and the car.
Yeah, and with the Mission E Cross Turismo, we combined some multiple vehicle purposes and we did something with the Panamera Sport Turismo last year as well.
Yeah, I mean, the Panamera Sport Turismo, the key was versatility. In the case of the Mission E, the Cross Turismo, the focus was more on this combination of different vehicle characteristics. So this car is perfect for the daily driving as well as for the off-road adventure. Take this car in the morning to the meeting in the city, and in the evening, you go to your chalet in the Swiss mountains.
And with the interior of the car, you focused on a high level of versatility.
Yeah, for example, on the backrests of the seats, you have a hatch to store skis, or you just fold them down.
Yeah, in the luggage compartment, there is a practical rail system with adjustable belts, and it allows to store big things and to fix them quickly.
I mean, definitely a car for active and sporty people. No matter which kind of sports you like, this car is always the perfect partner.
Yeah, so Michael, this is a concept study. What do you think? Should we bring it to serious production?
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely an interesting question. Maybe I'm the wrong person to be asked because I have spent so much time with the team But a motor show and the Geneva Motor Show is definitely a good place to find out if this car has potential.
So, Meyer, thank you very much for your professional comments. I think with the Cross Turismo, our design team has once again done a good job. I find the unique concept and the design instantly convincing. In my opinion, there's a good prospect for serious production very soon. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you all for coming. I hope you have enjoyed both the new GT3 RS and the Mission E Cross Turismo, which stand for important pillars of the Porsche product strategy. Have a good time in Geneva and enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Porsche executives are now available for photo opportunities on stage.